Good morning, and thank you all for being here. We're here today to talk about some of the good work that has occurred with APD to crack down on violent crime in our city. Before I turn the podium over to Chief Bryant, I want to touch on just a few things. First and foremost, I want to say that the men and women of the Atlanta Police Department who wake up each and every day to put their lives on the line on behalf of our community to keep us safe, I just want to say thank you for all the hard work that you each do in this department. And here are a few statistics that I'm eager to share with you today. Year to date, APD has seized a total of 284 firearms. Think about that. That's 284 firearms that could have been used for violent crimes, and they are now off the streets. Arrests for aggravated assaults are up 18% this year. Arrests for murder are up 283% from last year. Arrests for robbery are up 47% from last year. And finally, our pre-arrest diversions are up 46% this year. Those stats are all, they should show solid police work and solid community work together. As a reminder, we just recently launched the Repeat Offenders Tracking Unit to hold career criminals accountable and to bring them to justice. We will soon make an announcement about our Court Watch program, where residents can keep an eye on cases as they make their way through the system. And with the information that Chief Bryant is about to share with you, it is evident that the City of Atlanta and our partners are leveraging all available resources to collectively keep Atlantans safe. When I first took office, I attended roll calls in each and every precinct, and on each shift, I kept hearing from our officers the frustration that they have when they apprehend a criminal, they go off to jail, but then they come right back out only to be apprehended again and again. We talked about this recently. This just has to stop. We're hoping that the arrest you will hear about today will be indeed the very last time these individuals are arrested. Arresting repeat offenders and ensuring there is truly justice for the violent crimes that they commit in our courts is not only good for public safety, but it is good for police morale. I've said it before and I will say it again. Atlanta has the best police force in the nation, and I am grateful to each and every member of this police team. And it takes a special kind of courage to be a law enforcement officer and to have tragic incidents of violence reported on the news each and every day, and there's this tragedy that could be averted, and their bravery is standing there helping this public. And so now I would like to turn this over to Chief Bryant to update you on the significant arrests that have been made. Chief.
Thank you so much, Mayor, and good morning. I'll start by letting you know we deployed the fugitive unit. They work with hand in hand with our officers on the street on a regular basis, but what we initiated just before spring break, we had a collaboration of law enforcement officers throughout the metro area, and we recognized that we wanted to get ahead of some of the violence that we were seeing. Typically, we take a snapshot of what we see during spring break and devise our plan to go into the summer. We did something a little bit different where we implemented a more collaborative approach to addressing spring break, and the fugitive unit was a strong component of what we did this time. And so I think it's important that we talk about the great work that the fugitive unit did, and we're gonna do it by a slide presentation. As you can tell, this exercise, this deployment was between March 12th and April 7th, so it encompassed most of what you would have had during spring break. We were able to issue out 57 fugitive packages. A fugitive package is an investigative file that is handed over to an investigator after a case has been devised and a warrant is now out for that individual. It is now up to a fugitive investigator to use utilize their technology and skill set to go apprehend this individual. 12 of the fugitives were arrested for the offense of murder. On April 6th alone, the fugitive unit conducted a crime suppression and crime suppression units. Our federal, state, and local partners apprehended 13 wanted individuals in one day. This was a strategic day that we worked collaboratively with our surrounding agencies in the metro area. And so each individual department went out on this particular day to target fugitives, and Atlanta came away with arresting 13. Collectively, these suspects have been arrested more than 365 times. Again, this goes back to what the mayor talked about as it relates to repeat offenders. 365 times, as we can all agree, is a lot of numbers. One of the suspects had 37 arrests alone. The second to that person had 36. Go to the next slide. It shows you the number of the numbers broken down individually as it relates to the crimes that these individuals were arrested for. It went everywhere from murder down to auto theft. Aggravated assault clearly was the number that stood out the most, where we arrested 31 individuals for aggravated assault, 12 for murder, 5 for armed robberies, 4 for cruelty to children, 2 for aggravated assault, 1 for child molestation, 1 for homicide by vehicle, and 1 for theft of stolen auto. The next one is a more significant arrest. This is the fugitive arrest that of Brandon Williams and Demetrius Ross. These are the individuals that were responsible, were arrested for the arrest of the incident that occurred on the Beltline. Again, this is in collaboration with the great work of our homicide unit, as well as the fugitive unit, to make this arrest. Additionally, sadly, there are often times that we are after juveniles as well. And so this was, we had a significant shooting that played out at the fair that was near the Alterna Field. We were able to apprehend two individuals as it relates to this shooting as well. Antonio Lachlan was arrested on 324 for his involvement in an aggravated assault that played out on February the 26th. The uniqueness of Antonio Lachlan is he is the individual that had 37 prior arrests. And then our fugitive arrests of note. On 4-6-22, officers arrested another juvenile for his involvement in auto thefts. Auto theft tend to be a significant problem for us in the downtown space. We utilize our ACE, our auto crime enforcement unit, to really target individuals that are breaking into cars and stealing cars. And they too have their list of individuals that they find to be more prolific in their activities. This individual was a juvenile, and we were able to apprehend this juvenile as well. The Atlanta Police Department Fugitive Unit has closed more than 200 fugitive packages since 2020. And in various parts of crime are committed throughout the city. We could not do this work alone. We do this in collaboration with the federal marshals, Fulton County Sheriff, our federal and state partners, as well as our other local municipalities. Again, we do this in collaboration and understanding that criminals have no boundaries, that they are not specific to just the city of Atlanta. So it takes us working in unity and with them collaboration to make sure that we make this whole region safe. With that being said, I'll turn this over now to our new assistant chief, Assistant Chief Shearbaum.
Thank you, Chief Bryant. Mr. Mayor, as you're here today, you're seeing 57 individuals that this department has apprehended over the last few days. But what we do not want to forget that there's 57 families who are victims behind these perpetrators. That our officers went to work, our investigators went to work committing hundreds of hours to identify who was responsible for these crimes. In addition to 57 families who were impacted, there were scores of neighborhoods in our city who their sense of safety and security was impacted and dealt a blow because of these individuals. And for hundreds of hours, not only did we identify who was responsible, then we sought to apprehend them. Not an easy task. And these 57 individuals were apprehended with no violence reoccurring within any of our communities. All officers came home safe, and all perpetrators were taken to a detention center safely. Also in those 57 apprehensions was the community's involvement. Tips of Crime Stopper, sharing of video cameras, assisting our investigators. So as we speak with our federal and state partners who were shoulder to shoulder with this, the community was with us shoulder to shoulder as we brought these 57 individuals to justice. But now these 57 individuals move to a courtroom. And it is our hope, our desire, and our request that the courts will amplify the work of this police department, the work of our partners, the work of the community, and the expectations of these families and community that their wisdom and their action will make sure that safety is delivered to our neighborhoods because of the work of our officers. Thank you.
Good morning, Ralph Wolfolk, Atlanta Police Homicide Unit. I was asked by Public Affairs to give a brief update regarding arrests having been made by our very elite unit this week. The men of the Atlanta Police Department Homicide Unit continue to work very hard. Despite the challenges of a 40% increase in homicide this year, we do continue to solve cases at a rate that is second to none. The men and women of this unit truly do some astounding work. This week, we did have a case at 990 Newtown Circle where Mr. Henderson, a 25-year-old male, was shot to death in reference to, once again, an escalating dispute. These escalating disputes continue to account for the majority of our homicides, and being 40% of our homicides are attributed to escalating dispute this year. This incident occurred at an apartment complex outdoor, which accounts for 38% of our incidents this year. So we continue to ask the apartment complexes to do what they can to ensure the safety of persons on their properties. Mr. Draymond Mitchell, 27 years old, with a 12-cycle criminal history, was brought into custody, and this was as a result of, once again, relentless work that involved three different entities of our homicide team, forensic cell phone experts, a team that deals with crime scene processing and biological evidence, as well as a team that deals specially with interview and interrogation and those specific skill sets. So this was a team effort once again. Another significant arrest regarding this week was at 1959 Metropolitan Parkway. A second individual responsible for that homicide was taken into custody in reference to Mrs. Lakevia Jackson, 31 years old, who was shot in a parking lot there. That too was attributed to an escalating dispute. This incident also involved a handgun that accounts for 88% of our homicides year to date. 88% of our incidents, there is a handgun that is used in reference to that murder. And this is Mrs. Imani Spears, 24 years old, and she was brought into custody with no criminal history, while her co-conspirator, Mr. Joshua Fleetwood, has already been arrested. He had a 16-cycle criminal history in reference to this incident. And finally, we had an incident at 899 MLK Jr. Drive back on January 29th, and where Mr. Zaquan Lee, 20 years old, was pronounced deceased on scene. This too was an argument, once again, an escalating dispute in which a young man was pronounced deceased on scene. This involved a club establishment. 6 of 51 of our incidents this year involve clubs in our city. And once again involved a handgun. We arrested Mr. Quintavius Collier, 22 years old, with a 9-cycle criminal history regarding this incident. And also Mr. Tyree Peel, 20 years old, with a 4-cycle criminal history. So oftentimes what the public does not see on the back end, once homicide is able to do the excellent work in which this unit does, we bounce what is probably at times a more difficult task to our fugitive team, which is about to come and talk about what they do to bring these individuals in custody. So this is after these individuals are certainly running from some of the most heinous crimes in which they know that they are about to be processed for adjudication, and they're doing everything that they can to get away. But despite those challenges, this fugitive team does an exceptional job and delivering for us each and every time and providing us these individuals that we've taken our murder charges on. Thank you.
Hello, Lieutenant Brandon Pitts. I'm over the Fugitive Unit. The Chief spoke briefly about what we do. They asked me to come speak a little further on that. So as Lieutenant Wolfolk and the Chief spoke about, we've got some good detectives, great detectives on the Atlanta Police Department. And after they conduct their work and take out the warrants on violent felonies and crimes against children, come to the Fugitive Unit, where I have a group of men and women that I'm convinced are some of the hardest working detectives on the department. And we do everything within our means to take them into custody. Some of the things that do help with catching these criminals is Crime Stoppers. I can think of a few tips in the past week that have led, the past weeks that have led to arrest. And it's a crucial help to the Fugitive Unit. Our partners with Fulton County, DeKalb, United States Marshals, Secret Service are a huge help in the apprehension of these criminals. And as I said before, we'll do everything within our means to capture the criminals, one of which was today, Mr. Collier. This morning we captured him. So I would just encourage the criminals within the city of Atlanta to turn themselves in. If you have a warrant out for your arrest, save yourself the hassle of us coming and looking for you, because we will find you. And Lieutenant Wolfolk, the chiefs, the mayor have all spoke about escalating disputes, people losing their temper, and it leading to gunfire or murder. I would encourage those that come and patronize the city of Atlanta to think about the consequences of your action before you act. A 1-second decision can lead to lifelong consequences.